Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death.
Behold the handmaid of the Lord.
Be it unto me according to your word.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death.
And the Word was made flesh.
And dwelt among us.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death.
Pray for us, O Holy Mother of God,
that we may be made worthy of the promises of Christ.
We beseech you, O Lord, to pour your grace into our hearts, that as we have known the incarnation of your Son, Jesus Christ, by the message of an angel, so by his cross and passion, we may be brought to the glory of his resurrection, through the same Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Lord, open our lips,
and our mouths shall proclaim your praise.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever.
Amen.
The Lord is full of compassion and mercy. Come, let us adore. Come, let us sing to the Lord. Let us shout for joy to the rock of our salvation. Let us come before his presence with thanksgiving, and raise loud shouts to him with songs. For the Lord is a great God, and a great King above all gods. In his hand are the caverns of the earth, and the heights of the hills are his also. The sea is his, for he made it, and his hands have molded the dry land. Come, let us bow down and bend the knee, and kneel before the Lord our Maker. For he is our God, and we are the people of his pasture and the sheep of his hand. Oh, that today you would hearken to his voice. The Lord is full of compassion and mercy. Come, let us adore him. Psalm 18. Hear, O shepherd of Israel, leading Joseph like a flock. Shine forth you that are enthroned upon the cherubim.
In the presence of Ephraim, Benjamin, and Manasseh, stir up your strength and come to help us.
Restore us, O God of hosts. Show the light of your countenance, and we shall be saved.
O Lord God of hosts, how long will you be angered despite the prayers of your people?
You have fed them with the bread of tears. You have given them bowls of tears to drink.
You have made us the derision of our neighbors, and our enemies laugh us to scorn.
Restore us, O God of hosts. Show the light of your countenance, and we shall be saved.
You have brought a vine out of Egypt. You cast out the nations and planted it.
You prepared the ground for it. It took root and filled the land.
The mountains were covered by its shadow, and the towering cedar trees by its boughs.
You stretched out its tendrils to the sea, and its branches to the river.
Why have you broken down its wall, so that all who passed by took off its grapes?
The wild boar of the forest has ravaged it, and the beasts of the field have grazed upon it.
Turn now, O God of hosts, look down from heaven. Behold and tend this vine. Preserve where your right hand has planted.
They burn with fire like a bush. At the rebuke of your countenance, let them perish.
Let your hand be upon the man of your right hand, the Son of Man you have made so strong for yourself.
And so will we never turn away from you. Give us life that we may call upon your name.
Restore us, O Lord God of hosts. Show the light of your countenance, and we shall be saved.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever.
Amen. A reading from the book of Genesis. Then Judah stepped up to Joseph and said, O my Lord, let your servant please speak a word in your Lord's ears, and do not be angry with your servant, for you are like Pharaoh himself. "Have you a father or a brother?" And we said to the Lord, "We have a father, an old man, and a young brother, the child of his old age. His brother is dead. He alone is left of his mother's children, and his father loves him." Then you said to your servants, "Bring him down to me, so that I may set my eyes on him." We said to my Lord, "The boy cannot leave his father, for if he should leave his father would die." Then you said to your servants, "Unless your youngest brother comes down with you, you shall see my face no more." When we went back to your servant, my father, we told him the words of my Lord. And when our father said, "Go again, buy us a little food," we said, "We cannot go down. Only if our youngest brother goes with us, we will go down, for we cannot see the man's face unless our youngest brother is with us." Then your servant, my father, said to us, "You know that my wife bore me two sons. One left me, and I said, 'Surely he has been torn to pieces. I have never seen him since.' If you take this one also from me and harm him, and harm comes to him, you will bring down my gray hairs in sorrow to Sheol. Now therefore, when I come to you, your servant, my father, and the boy is not with us, then as his life is bound up in the boy's life, when he sees that the boy is not with us, he will die. Your servants will bring down the gray hairs of your servant our father with sorrow to Sheol. For your servant became surety for the boy to my father, saying, 'If I do not bring him back to you, then I will bear the blame in the sight of my father all my life.' Now therefore, please let your servant remain as a slave to my lord in the place of the boy, and let the boy go back with his brothers. For how can I go back to my father if the boy is not with me? I fear to see the suffering that would come upon my father." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. The first psalm of Isaiah. Surely it is God who saves me. I will trust in him and not be afraid. For the Lord is my stronghold and my sure defense, and he will be my savior. Therefore you shall draw water with rejoicing from the springs of salvation. And on that day you shall say, "Give thanks to the Lord and call upon his name. Make his deeds known among the people. See that they remember that his name is exalted. Sing the praises of the Lord, for he has done great things. And this is known in all the world. Cry aloud, inhabitants of Zion, ring out your joy. For the great one who is in you is the Holy One of Israel. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen."
A reading from the Gospel according to Mark. When Jesus had crossed again in the boat to the other side, a great crowd gathered around him, and he was by the sea. Then one of the leaders of the synagogue, named Jairus, came to him. When he had saw him, fell at his feet and begged him repeatedly, "My little daughter is at the point of death. Come and lay your hands on her, so that she may be made well and live." So he went with him, and a large crowd followed him and pressed him on him. Now there was a woman who had been suffering from hemorrhages for 12 years. She had endured much under many physicians, and had spent all that she had, and she was no better, but rather grew worse. She had heard about Jesus, and came behind him in the crowd, and touched his cloak, for she said, "If I but touch his clothes, I will be made well." Immediately her hemorrhage stopped, and she felt in her body that she was healed of her disease. Immediately aware that the power had gone forth from him, Jesus turned about in the crowd and said, "Who touched my clothes?" And his disciples said to him, "You see the crowd pressing in on you? How can you say, 'Who touched me?'" He looked all around to see who had done it, but the woman, knowing what had happened to her, came in fear and trembling, fell down before him, and told him the whole truth. He said to her, "Daughter, your faith has made you well. Go in peace and be healed of your disease." When he was still speaking, some people came from the leader's house to say, "Your daughter is dead. Why trouble the teacher any further?" Jesus said to the leader of the synagogue, "Do not fear, only believe." He allowed no one to follow him except Peter, James, and John, the brother of James. When they came to the house of the leader of the synagogue, he saw a commotion, people weeping and wailing loudly. When he had entered, he said to them, "Why do you make a commotion and weep? The child is not dead, but sleeping." And they laughed at him. Then he put them all outside and took the child's father and mother and those who were with them and went in where the child was. He took her by the hand and said to her, "Talitha kum," which means, "Little girl, get up." And immediately the girl got up and began to walk about. She was 12 years of age. At this time they were overcome with amazement. He strictly ordered them no one should know this, and told them to give her something to eat. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. The Song of the Redeemed. O ruler of the universe, O God, great deeds of thy name that you have done, surpassing the human understanding. Your ways are ways of righteousness and truth. O King of all the ages, who can fail to do you homage, Lord, and sing the praises of your name? For you are the God of the one God. All nations will draw near and fall down before you, because your just and holy works have been revealed. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
I believe in God,
Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth.
I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord.
He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit, and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial, and deliver us from evil. The kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. Save your people, Lord, and bless our inheritance.
Govern and uphold them, now and always.
Day by day we bless you.
We praise your name forever.
Lord, keep us from all sin today.
Have mercy on us, Lord, have mercy.
Lord, show us your love and mercy.
For we put our trust
in you, Lord, is our hope.
For we shall never hope in vain.
Almighty God, you know that we have no power in ourselves to help ourselves. Keep us both outwardly in our bodies and inwardly in our souls, that we may be defended from all adversities which may happen to the body, and from all evil thoughts which may assault and hurt the soul. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Almighty and everlasting God, you hate nothing you have made, and forgive the sins of all who are penitent. Create and make in us new and contrite hearts, that we, worthy of lamenting our sins and acknowledging our wretchedness, may obtain of you, the God of all mercy, perfect remission and forgiveness. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
God, the author of peace and love of concord, to know you is eternal life and to serve you is perfect freedom. Defend us, your humble servants, in all assaults of our enemies, that we, surely trusting your defense, may not fear the power of any adversaries, through the might of Jesus Christ our Lord. God, almighty and everlasting Father, you have brought us in safety to this union. Preserve us with your mighty power, that we may not fall into sin, nor be overcome by adversity. And in all we do this day, direct us in the fulfilling of your purpose. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
bless the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all ever.